हेलो फ्रेंड्स, टुडे आई एम हियर टू एक्सप्लेन द स्टैंडर्ड ऑपरेटिंग प्रोसीजर्स फॉर सेफ्टी इन लेबोरेटरी इन फार्मास्यूटिकल इंडस्ट्री। सो यू विल थिंक दैट ऑल ऑफ दीज एसओपीज और सेफ्टी प्रिकॉशंस वी हैव ऑलरेडी लर्नड इन बीएससी फर्स्ट ईयर, सो व्हाई देर इज रिपीटेशन। But friends, this will be a revision for your mind, because after 5 years of learning all these standard operating procedures or precautions which have to taken in our microbiology laboratory, that should be revised, and all these standard operating procedures, it will be useful for your interview preparations. So knowledge of these SOPs for the safety in laboratory in pharmaceutical industry, that will be helpful for your pharma interviews. So watch this whole video, and if you have not subscribed this Microbiology by Santosh Napte, so don't forget to subscribe this channel. So let's start with the first slide here. And our title is Standard Operating Procedures for Safety in Quality Control Laboratory in Pharmaceutical Industry. The main objective of this slide or video is to describe a procedure for maintaining safety in the laboratory. That is because it is very essential to know the procedure for the maintenance of safety in the laboratory. And all of you know that safety should be priority or on priority. So, and when you are applying for these jobs in pharmaceutical industry, so knowledge of these safety control measurements, that will be very essential, and that's why you must know all these things. The scope of this SOP is that procedures applies to the quality control laboratory in the manufacturing facility, and the responsibility is of the officer of the quality control department or the executive of quality control department, and the accountability is of the manager from quality control department. So this is the procedure for the standard operating procedures. So first we will see the guidelines for personal laboratory safety. So this personal laboratory safety in pharmaceutical industry or any lab, it is very essential. So you have to keep in mind that, or you have to follow all these laboratory safety which are related to your personal. So eating, drinking or smoking in the laboratory should be strictly prohibited. Second personal laboratory safety is use of safety goggles for eye protection while handling corrosive as well as highly toxic materials. Next one is here, wear lab coats when you are handling corrosive, toxic or flammable materials. Then wear gloves when handling corrosive and highly toxic materials. Next personal laboratory safety is know where safety equipments, that may be eye wash, that may be fire extinguishers, these are located, and how to use these safety equipments, that you have to know. Do not carry corrosives by the mouth of the bottle. Then never pipette out corrosive liquids by mouth. Use a pipetting bulb or the other mechanical pipetting devices, because pipetting of corrosive liquids by mouth, sometimes that directly enters your mouth and that causes the harm. Then do not attempt to identify chemicals by smell or by taste. Never sniff reagents, especially corrosive materials. Know how to clean up spills of the chemicals that you use. Wash your hands after handling chemicals and before leaving the lab. Then bare legs are not acceptable when handling hot, cold, toxic or corrosive chemicals. Then iWatch facilities should be within easy access. Keep appropriate safety equipment readily available and properly maintained to prevent or respond to such laboratory emergencies as personal contamination, fires, spills or splashes. Then obey the two-person rule. A second person should be aware that you are working in the laboratory. So these are the very basic things, but these are very important for the laboratory safety as well as for your interview also. So that's why you must know all these things. Then this is the checklist for preliminary hazard analysis. Always check the safety precautions for the material you are using to understand the specific hazards involved. Review the characteristics of all reagents, reactants in terms of flammability, toxicity as well as reactivity hazards, and where information is not available about that particular reagents or chemical, then you have to treat all these materials as a hazardous material. So precautions you have to take. What is the type of hazard, that is inhalation, ingestion, eye or skin contact? What protective measures are required, that you have to know? What is the recommended first aid in case of accidental exposure? You also know these things here. Then can waste be safely handled and arrangements for disposal completed? All you have to check. Then safety controls. Engineering controls are always the best choice for regulating hazardous materials, and you have to use all these engineering controls wherever applicable. Then there should be fume hoods as well as local exhaust hoods. Next one is here, that is about the chemical storage. So the chemical storage, it should be under the supervision of a qualified person. Storerooms must have adequate security. So whatever that chemical storage or chemicals you are having in that laboratory, that should be under the supervision of a well qualified person or experienced person. Then conduct an annual inventory. So each year you have to remove the surplus hazardous chemicals from that storage, to remove chemicals that will not or have not been used in the past 1 to 3 years. Then to correct incompatible storage, to identify which chemicals are present, or to conduct a regular cleanup of containers as well as shelving. The next one is here, that is about the general rules. So shelving should be accessible with chemicals at eye level or lower level. No high shelf storage will be there. Avoid floor chemical storage, because that chemical should not be stored at the floor. Then do not overcrowd shelves. Chain compressed gas cylinders. Then keep solvent containers closed. Ensure that chemical containers are intact. Also ensure that container lids are intact and closed, and regularly vent materials capable of building up pressure, for example formic acid. Then for emergencies, that laboratory must have the fire extinguishers of the approved type positioned near an escape route, spill control as well as cleanup materials. So this is about the general rules. Then about the labels on that chemicals. So labels of contents should be clearly mentioned or written. That labels must be intact as well as legible, and they do not overwrite labels. Refrigerator storage. Then in the event that chemicals need to be stored in a refrigerator, follow the rules which are listed on that container, for example, or that materials must be secured, packaged, tightly sealed as well as properly labeled. Then also ensure that materials, especially those that are highly reactive or corrosive, are inspected regularly, and also inspected that the lids are intact. And these are the abbreviations here. NA for not applicable, NO means number, SOP means standard operating procedures, QC means quality control, and BNO means batch number. So friends, watch this whole video and share with your friends, and kindly subscribe this Microbiology by Santosh Napte. Thank you.